Welcome at video number 80 of the EEP10 model railway simulator. This video is again about a Lua code for model railroad automation. And in the previous two videos we have been doing the same. We tried first the random input-output combined with single track protection. That worked well. Then, to have minimized code, we went to a situation to have Lua with block control. That also went well. But both situations had a little drawback. And that is when you would like to have a certain type of train to be allocated to a station to go to only, say, lane 1. For instance, I have a passenger train here ready. And I wanted to go to the next station, but it's only allowed to go to lane 1. And opposed to that, maybe cargo trains are only allowed to go to lane 2 and 3. That is a situation that's quite common, and many people would like to do that on their layouts. And the previous two videos, the Lua code did not allow for that. And in this video we're going to have a look at code that does allow for that, and it is even not difficult to use. So let's go ahead and have a look. Here is our well-known layout in the meantime. What do we see over here? Well, we still have this station north with 1, 2, 3, 4 tracks, then a single track on the west and a single track on the east. And over here we have a south station with track 1 and track 2. This train is obviously going that way and can only go to north 4. And this train is going that way and it can only go to north 1, 2 or 3. And so on. Over here I added something that we did not have in previous two methods. That is a range of extra sensors. That the only purpose of it is to save the situation so that at the next startup the software can figure out where the trains are. So that is, well, yeah, that can come in handy. And there's one main switch over here with which I can start or temporarily pause the code. And these are switches that could be used to release trains from the stations, but in this code we don't use them. So that is what happened. What will happen if I start the code? Oh, that I should do over here and start the code. Yes. Well, you see that the both trains that have a free track over here and over here, they go. Well, obviously that's okay, because the software takes care of looking where is a free route. It's actually block based plus route based, so what we need to do, we do not have to write any software. You can download the software, it is in the text that goes with the video. All you need to do is parameterize it, so you fill in some tables with data, and we are going to have a look at that in a minute. In this situation, there is nothing special yet. The special thing that we are going to add in the next video probably is this, that we have over here this steam train, and I'm going to add a little situation that the steam train that is going here to station south 1 in the next video, it's only allowed to go to station north track 1. So that is one of those situations where you have a specific train you want to allocate to a certain track, and that's all quite easy to do in this software. You just have to add a block and a sensor, and that's it. Well, as you can see, the trains are running smoothly. They find a free track. Over here you have the window that shows which blocks are free or occupied or reserved, and as soon as a route is free, which is happening just now, this orange train, the route from here to the east and then to station north 4 was free, so then it goes. Over here we have two trains, they are competing. I mean, there's this single track, and well, this one had a free route over here to station south 1, and this one also had a free route to station north, and you can see over here it is still requesting that station south track 2 to station north track 4. There's a request to go, but obviously because this block is occupied, it cannot yet go. So, well, let's wait for a second when this steam engine, the last wagon, has passed my mouse over here, then you will see the other train will go. And you will see a lot happening here in the window. Yes, a lot happened, and there it goes. So, let's have a look at how this works. And then in the next video, let's have a look what we need to add if we want to allocate this steam engine to be only allowed to North 1. Okay, so we are going to stop this and now dive into the code. The code is over here. Let's scroll up and let me zoom in a bit so that on the video it is also possible to maybe see what's written here. I will just walk through what is in the code that does not need to be changed. We don't look at it, we only look at the things that you need to change to get your own layout inside this code. Well, at line 1 or 2 it says go to line 50 to configure your layout. So let's do that. Line 50 is over here, so I do not have to do anything before that. Okay, there are some things to read, to take care of, some important things you need to know. And then it says, please fill in. Yes, then we have hold and fart as a variable, and with some signals, hold is 1 and fart is 2, and with some other signals, that's just the other way around. So you need to take care. You cannot mix the two types of signals in one layout. Well, you can, but that will make life more difficult. Then we have a switch that is our main switch. We fill in the number. That was this switch over here. This one, it obviously has a number, and I use that for my main pause switch. So I just fill in the number there, and then I have a possibility to temporarily pause the program execution. And also over here I can say at startup, do I want to stop or do I immediately want to start? Well, I always like to stop because then I can first see if all the signals are right and so forth in the testing phase. Okay, so that's a little initialization, and that's actually all. And then we are going to define our blocks. It asks for create your block definitions. Well, obviously we have a few blocks where trains can stop, or blocks where trains need to drive through, and we need to define them. And that is done in this table. If you have more blocks than these 8 over here, obviously you just copy and paste these lines and add more blocks, as many as you need. Let's have a look at our layout. We have here 1, 2, 3, 4 blocks of station north, and then 1, 2 at station south, and 1 block at the west, and 1 block here at the east. So I have 8 blocks in total. And in the code we see that exactly we have exactly 8 blocks. And what do we need to fill in? Well, it says over here exactly what you need to fill in. The first thing is we can give it a name that is only used in the printout, so it's not very important what name you give it, but if you have a larger layout, it is just easy to give the block a name instead of just having a number. That's more difficult to remember. Then we have to say if the block is reserved and if the block is occupied by a train. Well, at initialization, at startup, we just fill in false and false, so no block is reserved. The software will figure that out itself. It's just that we need to have those flags over here. Then we have to define the signal. I don't know why it says signal 1, it is just a signal. We have to define the number of the signal on the block. Well, obviously many blocks have a signal, like North 1, 2, 3 and North 4. They all have a signal on them, so we give the number of that signal. We also have blocks that do not have a signal. Over here we have the east block. Well, that is always a drive-through. It's a single track. Trains can go from in this direction and in this direction, and I don't want them to stop there. So it's just a via route and there is no signal on. How do we handle that in the code? Well, the blocks that have a signal, we just mention the signal, and the blocks that don't have a signal, we say we give it a dummy number 999 or whatever, but a large enough number that is not a real signal on your layout. Then we the next number that we have to enter is the number of the memory signals. What we had here is a bunch of signals. These are only meant for the startup phase. If you have saved your layout and start up the code, then the code is going to check where are the trains, and that's stored in these dummy signals that are just as a sort of internal memory, acting as an internal memory. And we have to obviously give the numbers of those signals. So every block has a memory signal. That's all. Then you see a bunch of zeros at the end. That's what we're going to talk in the next video. So for now, we just keep those at zero. That's all we need to do. Every block has been defined. And then also we have not to forget to also mention the maximum number of blocks that is obviously going to be used somewhere in the code later. Are we done? No, we are not done, because we do not only have blocks, we also have to define for our layout what routes do we have. And a route is just a trajectory going from one block to another block, maybe via another block. That's what we have to define also. So I say I want to have a route from station north to one, track one, to station south, track one. And that obviously was coming from block one, going to block seven, via block five. Then I have to set one junction. The number of that junction is two, and I have to set it to vaart. That's what I have to fill in for all the routes that I want to have on my layout. Well, we are not going to do walk through all of this, but you just simply look at your layout and you decide for yourself what routes you want to have. Let's for instance have a look at this steam engine. It is here on station south 1, and I want to have a route via the east block to station north 4. And I don't want this train to station north 1, 2, 3. I don't want this train to end up at track 4. So what I need to have is three routes from station 1 to station north 1, 2, 3. Well, let's go back to our code and see if we have filled that in properly. We are able to go from south 1 to north 1, yes. Also from south 1 to north 2, yes. And also from south 1 to north 3. And we filled in carefully from block to block, via block, and then the junctions that we need to switch, and if they are going to be switched to vaart or abzweig. Well, it's not difficult, but obviously it's easy to make a mistake. And well, yeah, okay, if that happens, then you have to test, of course, if it's all working okay. But if you fill that in correct, then you are not done. We read on. You can use the manual switches to release trains, but we don't do that. And we read on. Now, first copy the software to EEP and run it once. Yes, why? Well, we are going to place some track signals that are going to point to Lua functions, and it won't work unless we first enter the code and run it once. And then we will place the train available sensors and the block free sensors. Let's have a look at what we mean by that. We go to 2D mode. And let's just have a few examples. Over here we have track north 4. That is a track driving in this direction. So just before the signal, we want to tell the Lua code there is now a train available. These yellow signals are sound signals, and I always use those for available. And you can see over here which function is called train available for track 4. aha, this is a parameter. Yes, this guy Benny, that's obviously a WizKid, he published a piece of code on the forum, and since that moment we are able to use parameters in function calls from sensors. So that's also built into this software, and we thankfully thank Benny for inventing that, and we can now use that. So all you need to do is define your blocks, define your routes, and place the sensors, and nothing else. Okay, so that's how it works. We have train available sensor, and well, the opposite is of course, if the train is leaving the track, then over here, I use the purple ones for that, that is a Fahrzeug signal, then we say, we call the function block free for block number 4. And we keep on doing that for all the blocks. So let's have a look at here at South 2. Block South 2, you won't be surprised if I click this, that the function that we are going to call is train available for block 8. And over here, the block 3 for block 8. Well, why block 8? Well, obviously block 8 is the block for South 2. That's of course what we have just been defining. Over here we see block 8 is South 2. That's why I give them a name, that's easier to reference them. Okay, now we are done. We have filled in our blocks, then we filled in our routes, and don't forget to fill in the number of routes that you have. Then we placed all the signals. And thanks to the code of Benny, we don't have to do anything else. All the code is below here. You don't have to change anything below here. Well, here is the code. We are not going to talk about it. That is a bit more complex than it was before. But that doesn't matter that it is a bit more complex, because all you have to do is fill in your block definitions and fill in your route definitions. And that is not very difficult. It's just that you don't you cannot make any mistakes or it won't work. All right, well, that's it. Let's have a final look at a train driving around. Let me click over here, and then I stop my software by just clicking this, and then I will see at the end I have 3 trains, so I need to see here in my memory 3 green lights, and then I can save my layout, and then at startup it will know what is happening. That's of course also important, that you don't mess up at startup of Lua code. Okay, so this train north has arrived, as we can see over here, and let's just wait until the steam engine has arrived that will light up this number, block number 3. Let's see, and if that happened, then all is okay, and I can save the layout. Well, I think it's almost there. Yes, there it is. Now all my trains are at a block and they are noticed, and I can now save the layout, and it at startup I will get a proper startup again. Okay, thank you for watching. The next video, it is the same software, but we will add a block and a route to have the situation where we want a specific train to go to a specific track, something that many people like to use on their layouts.